Alright, good morning, Fit Fam. How you guys doing? I hope you guys having a blessed week so far. So I told y'all when I bought out the expert tutelage video, I was actually going to link or actually put the conversation out with Mike, the personal trainer that I had with the personal trainer. I'm sorry, just woke up from Triumphant Fit. Now we talked for about an hour, and I actually have 10 minutes of the conversation. I don't want to make this one too long, so. This is for anybody that wants to be, that's inspiring to be a personal trainer, okay, like myself. This guy has some really good knowledge. I want to pick his brain, and he gave me some really good advice, and I just want to share it with you guys. So this is for anybody that wants to be a personal trainer. Here's 10 minutes, a good quality 10 minutes of the conversation that I had with Mike. So hope you guys enjoy it, and I will see y'all in the next vlog.
Corporate training, not with personal training, but in terms of sales and leadership development.
So
I've lived
okay,
in the corporate world for quite some time.
Okay, I got
in terms of just developing people and training people in their job capacity, right, to be better salespeople, to be better in their customer experience delivery, to be better managers, to be better leaders. I've taught CEOs of companies, right? And we think about once we gain a certain amount of knowledge or expertise, or we have something that we're willing to share with someone that we think can better them, right? We're giving them, and when you're training someone, right, you think of that as feedback. You can watch someone do a deadlift and give them feedback on how they're doing their deadlift, right? I could watch someone go grocery shopping and I can give them feedback on what they're buying. I could watch someone parent their children and I can give them feedback on their parenting. You can give feedback on anything. Once you feel you've got a level of expertise or knowledge about something that can help someone, what we have to be able to do is kind of put that on the back burner. Your knowledge is great, but we're going to look at that feedback, and I want you to think of it as a gift, okay? And I want to ask to literally think of a gift for a moment, okay? I want you to think of a gift. Close your eyes for a second. Think of a box, right? Think of the most amazing looking wrapped gift you've ever seen in your life, right? It's got maybe shiny, sparkly, holographic wrapping paper on it, right? It's got a bow that goes all the way around and on top, this ribbon that just sprawls all over the place. It's color coordinated, right? And my mother was great at wrapping gifts because she would wrap with the wrapping paper. You didn't see any of the seams. You didn't see any of the tape, nothing. It was just like, boom. It looked like it was ready for a magazine, right? Now when you see that gift, right, you go, that gift looks great, right? And now I want you to flip it, have a different image for a second. Have you ever had someone present someone or present you maybe with a gift and it was wrapped kind of crummy? Maybe they used newspaper, right? Masking tape all on the outside, no ribbon, no bows. It just looked kind of crummy. And they go, here you go. Now when you see those two gifts, you're going to respond differently. We don't know what's inside the box,
right?
But just based on how it's wrapped, I have one feeling or I have another, right? And one person has this gift that was wrapped real nice, and they put a lot of care and attention into the outside of that, because when they gave it to you, they wanted you to feel a certain way receiving it. And that gift you're probably very willing to receive. Now, what if it was another gift and it was just wrapped up, crumpled in a brown paper bag? And I go, here's your gift. If I rolled up to you with a brown, crumpled brown paper bag, you might be like, whoa, 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 what's in that bag? You don't know what's inside, but I want you to think of your feedback the very same way. It's not always about what you have to say, but it's about how you package it for that person. Do they want to take your gift from you, yes or no? All right? Effective trainers, effective coaches, effective personal trainers know how to take the knowledge they have, but go, now wait a minute. I was just working with Mrs. Smith an hour ago. Sweet, soft lady. And for her, I gotta say nice things to her. I gotta encourage her, I gotta motivate her. I gotta tell her she looks good. I gotta tell her she's doing good things. And then she listens to the tips and advice that I give her. If I take that same approach with Damien, I'm probably not gonna get the same results. I know when I'm training Damien, I gotta go, look, bro, what's up? I know you can do more than that, so why are you quitting on me? I ain't even taking that. Let's go. I'm still trying to get good results out of both people, but I have to package it differently if I really want to get the best out of you. If I choose to take my approach with every single person the same way, I'm only going to be effective with a few people. But if I can step back and figure out what makes you tick, take my message and go, I got it. I know what he needs today. And now give it to you in the way that you want to receive it, now I'm more effective with more people. So, am I saying you're wrong by saying you gotta be tough on people, you gotta be hard? Absolutely not. But can we take that concept of getting people to improve themselves but package it in a way that they want to take it from you? Because you may have a client that wants to work with you who's 70 years old and she's not trying to power lift or be crushing it in the gym, but she needs to improve her health, she's been overweight, she's got high blood pressure, and she needs a different kind of motivation. Maybe you can package your story and share it with her in a way that gets the results out of her too, differently than your guys that you bang weights with in the gym. That make sense?
So it's good to analyze. If I do get a client, it's good to do a day one analyzation. Basically, talk to them, maybe write down stuff.
Day one, day two, day three, day four, day five, it's always gonna change.
Change,
right?
Yeah.
Every day we gotta gauge them, right? If I'm working out with you, I'm gonna be checking you out from the time you walk in, right? You got
body,
your music.
Body language.
Right? Smile on your face, right? You got your water going, right? What's going on in your mind, right? Because I might have to approach what we're doing today a little bit differently to get the most out of you. I might even have to say, you know what, Damien? I'm not doing this today, my man. I don't think it's gonna be worth your time. And you've been in here doing legs 3 times this week. You wanna get better, you wanna get healthy, you wanna get stronger? Cool, go home. We're not working out today. Get your mind right, rest, come back tomorrow, we'll do it tomorrow. You know what I mean? I gotta judge all those things if I'm really gonna be the best help to my clients.
Makes perfect sense.
So what else?
That's really it. I was like, you know what, it's great, I mean, as I said, this is something I'll do in the future. I mean, this is something that I really am passionate about doing, is help people out. Because when I was homeless, people helped me get myself that self-sufficient. So I just want to be able to do the same thing for people who wants to live better health-wise. I'm 37, so, you know, getting people my age to know that there is no, you know, you can still do it. That'd be wonderful. That'd be wonderful for me. And, you know, I can carry that legacy down to my kids. You know, maybe my son wants to pick it up. You know, hey, even better.
Sure.
But that's something I really want to do. People ask questions all the time. I get every day, what can I do with this? What can I do with this? I love it. I love when they ask me those questions. I even stop my whole workout. Show them. You know, if I see somebody doing something wrong and they ask me, I'll stop a whole training session just to help them out.
That's cool. That's cool.
It's just I just wanna help. I just wanna inspire that one person. That's why I do YouTube. If I can inspire that one person, I'll keep making videos. And people hit me up all the time. They mention all the time, you inspire me to lose as much weight, or you inspire me to change my life, and that's what keeps me going. I don't care about having 100,000. I don't care if this. If I can hit that one person, I think I've done my job.
That's huge. Then you found your passion. You know, for me, I think what got me into it as well is I don't ever feel like I go to work. I don't work.
Mm-hmm.
I happen to do this thing that I can make a living on, but I do what I like doing. I can help other people.
And that's the other intention for me too. I'm just tired of working 9-to-5 jobs. Personally, I'd rather do my own thing. I'd rather, you know, go toot my own horn, I guess is the right term. I want to toot my own horn. I want to be able to travel again, but this time travel doing something that I love doing. not because I have to travel, because I have to do it for a job. I'm going to do it for my own job.
So what are we doing to differentiate ourselves? What is our educational path right now?
Well, like I said, right now, starting 23rd, which is what, 2 weeks away now, I think?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I'm taking a personal training certification class at Richmond College. That is actually, I actually have a degree in web design here already.
Okay.
So I do a little bit of web work myself. I reach all crowds, but I really want to tell it to the older crowd who think that they can't, they're too old. Well, we're too old to get healthy. Oh, okay, my body is terrible. My bones is this terrible. No, it's not that. It's just that you're not trying. You don't. You think you see this, and there's a whole other spectrum